Let's now work on a real signal. Real time series. In real, I mean something from the real world, not real valued. And the example is an ECG. ECG, so our sampling rate, FS, is 200 hertz, 200 hertz sampling rate. Oh, I should actually write this with a capital F, just to be in the convention here that capital ones are in the analog domain. So that's our FS, our sampling rate, 200 hertz. And so what we would like to see is the Fourier spectrum. So we do the same as before. So we load a sequence X or a sequence ECG into Python. And then we do in there the Fourier transform, the FFT, and then we show the spectrum. Okay, so let's do that. That's in a couple of steps. And so where's the Python environment here? So let's load this this file. So first again we need to import numpy as usual as np. So the file is called ecg.dat. So and that can be done with a numpy function, numpy load txt, and that's ecg.dat. So it's just a file containing all these samples. So if I do now X, so we see here there's a data in there. So the data is organized in the following form. So if I go back to this file here. So the ECG file, the data format is just a text file, and the text file looks like this. That we've got two columns here, and the first column is time, and the second one. Is the actual data? Yeah. So in this case, the ECG, and it goes down in this column here. So it's column number zero in this column number one. So what we would like to extract here, we want this here. Okay. So how do we do that? So we just do this with Python splicing. Python splicing. Okay. So let's do that. Let's just splice our ECG out of this file here. And so we've got this file just now in X, just to see that it's actually the case is. So if I say X of zero, that's basically the first sample, and this is again an array, and there's a one in there, and there's a 492 for the actual value. So the one, that's a timestamp, and that's the actual ECG value here. And so if I do now X of one, then here I see the next timestamp here, and what I should mention here here this time, this time here is actually in milliseconds. And so that's the reason why we see here in the Python here this timestamp is 1 and 6. So basically there so we've got 5 milliseconds evolving, and then this gives us 200 hertz sampling rate. Okay, so now we need to extract so this second column here, so these values. And so we just do this by ECG equals to X. So we would like to have everything from a column, and we would like to have the second column. Remember, it's counting from 1. And so if we do this now, so now we have extracted this second column here. Okay, so let's just plot this. So import matplotlib pyplot as plt. So again, abbreviating this here, and now we can do plt dot plot and the ECG. And here we have it. So that's the ECG what we have here. So these are the peaks here where the heart beats. This stuff here is actually noise, so we're going to take care of this later on. But it's interesting to see now how this looks like in the Fourier spectrum. So how do we do the spectrum? So let's do the spectrum XF. So that's our frequency numpy FFT subdirectory, and then the FFT command, and we're doing the Fourier transform on this. So now let's plot this. Plot absolute value of XF. Oops, that's forgotten to write PLT in front of that. And here we've got the spectrum now. So we see here, this is actually the spectrum of the actual ECG. This is here the DC component of the signal, and here we see these two peaks. They are actually representing the 50 hertz noise in the ECG. So now the problem is that this axis here just now, these are just samples. So we see the whole recording is a bit more than 1,000 samples long. And it has no meaning in terms of frequency, so we need to fix the frequency and the frequency axis. So how do we do that? Okay, so fixing the frequency axis. So let's just draw this here quickly again. And so here we've got, remember, these are just now frequency samples, so that's k. And then we've got here our x of k, or in this case here calls this here xf. And so our spectrum looks a bit like this, and then we had also these peaks here in there. And so just now the only thing what we know is that's n half, but we know this corresponds here to fs half. And so we know that's here end point here. So these are goes to n minus 1. And then this goes to zero here. And so these are just now only samples, and that's what we see in the plot here. So n is just the number of samples. And so if we look here at this plot again, so we see here these are samples. So that's basically just samples. So we need to map this onto frequency. But we know that this is here fs half, and then obviously, if this if n half is fs half, then n corresponds to to FS, to our sampling rate. So remember, sampling rate was in our case here 200 hertz. And so then the only thing what we need to do is here that we need to have another axis. And this runs here from 0 hertz to 200 hertz. And then in the middle here, we've got our 100 hertz. Remember, this is our mirror here, so therefore that's actually not really important. But we need to have this mapping here, and to do that, we can use to create a mapping between the samples here and the frequencies. There's a very convenient command in NumPy which is called linspace, so we can map with that. So let's just do this. So we need to create basically a frequency axis. Yeah. So this frequency axis, let's call this here F axis. And for that we use NumPy linspace, and linspace is just basically distributing samples evenly over the spectrum here. So we linspace, we want to have a range from 0 to 200 hertz. And how many samples do we have? We just steal that with the or obtain this with the command length of xf, and then just generate hopefully our axis here. So now what we can do is that we add this here to our plot command. And now we see that we have here you know, the peak at 50 hertz and at 150 hertz here. And so therefore with that we just have basically fixed this whole plot here. Okay, so now we have seen that we have got these peaks here. So the question is, so if this is unwanted frequency, so how can we use the Fourier transform to get rid of these ones here?